Hey, math class here. You're going to want a decent calculator, okay? So, for math, well, to do arithmetic, which isn't really math, all right? To do arithmetic, to speed things up, you're going to want to have a decent calculator. There's lots of different types of calculators, right? Here's a pretty good one that I recommend. You don't want a Dollarama one, though. See these Dollarama ones? Those are $3. You probably want to get one at Walmart. Don't go to Staples or double the price. So they look like that. And then here's another kind of similar one. All right, this is a 510. That's a 5. They all pretty much do the same thing. But you're going to want one that does a bunch of special features. The Dollarama one is not sufficient. Let me demonstrate why. So you're going to do 5 times 7 plus 4. All right, so I'll turn this on. 5 times 7 plus 4. All right, notice that everything I typed in is showing, and then it gives you the answer. So you know that you put it in right, which means you can be pretty sure the answer's right. Whereas if you do it on a Dollarama calculator, let's do 5 times 7 plus 4. 5 times 7. Oh, where'd the 5 go? And then plus. Oh, now it does it 35. Oh, man, now plus. Oh, man, what numbers did I type in? So you're never quite sure if you typed in the right numbers, so that means you got to do it twice to make sure you get the same calculation. All right, so a $3 Dollarama calculator is not sufficient. All right, and by the way, your phone isn't any better. All right, chances are on your phone, all right, chances are you got a calculator on your phone. All right, it doesn't work any. Well, here, let's do the scientific version, right? If you turn your phone sideways, of course, you get the better version. But notice it's no better, right? 5 times 7 plus 4. Notice it didn't show you what you typed in. So even your calculator phone probably is no better than a Dollarama one. All right, so you know what? You can always download an app on Play Store or Google Play, whichever app you use there. Let's have a look here. Let's go to my, here's one I just downloaded just now. It's free, right? Notice it will do the entire thing for you. 5 times 7 plus 4. Notice it shows you exactly what you typed in, so you can't possibly mess up. And then it gives you the answers down here. All right, so you got, that's a good calculator. There's a good calculator. They show you everything you typed in. The Dollarama calculator is not a good calculator. Another advantage of the Walmart $14 calculators is they do fractions. Some of you don't like fractions. If you don't like fractions, that's fine by me, right? All right, so you can do fractions. Let's do 3/4 plus 1/8. All right, so I'll clear that out. 3, fraction. See, that's your fraction button, ABC. You want an ABC button if your fractions really suck. So 3, fraction, 4, plus 1, ABC, 8. So it's got 3, hockey stick 4. I call it hockey stick. It can't do a forward slash, so it makes like a hockey stick. So that says 3/4 plus 1/8, and it tells you the answer 7/8. I hope you kind of knew that. All right, so it is nice to get a calculator that shows everything that you typed in, and it also does cut fractions. Fractions are kind of trivial. All right. And, oh, by the way, chances are you've seen this, right? These calculators have been around for almost 30 years. Every math teacher on the planet has used these for 30 years. Somebody in your family has one of these Texas Instruments. Often it's a TI-83. Okay, so ask around the family. Somebody's got one of those. If you're going to do applied math with me, you'll be using this for sure. Notice it shows everything you type in, and it can do really complicated stuff. And it can graph all kinds of neat stuff, too. All right, so this is really a built-in computer. Anyway, there's the type of calculator you want. At least go spend the $14 and get a decent Walmart one. I got a couple that I can sell you as well for $12. Complete.